You know, buying your first guitar can be quite daunting. There's so many different styles, models, and variants out there these days, some of which all look the same, but with huge price gaps. But don't you worry, guys. I'm Dagan from PMTV UK, and as always, I'm here to help. So when it comes to buying your first guitar, like I said, the options can be pretty overwhelming. So the best place to start is with your heart. Who's your guitar idol, the rock god that you aspire to be? There's so many awesome ones to choose from. Who's your inspiration? They will have chosen that guitar for a very specific reason. So if you want to start playing their stuff, rocking that look, and getting comfortable with that style of playing, follow in their footsteps. Let the guitar inspire you. For example, I'm a huge Angus Young fan. The reason I play guitar is because when I was a kid, I saw the Monsters of Rock show at Donington, not live, and I saw Angus Young rocking his SG. And from that moment, I was like, I love this band, I love this style of music, and I've pretty much played SGs ever since. And it's solely because of that one moment. So there's nothing wrong with grasping onto the thing you love and making it work for yourself. You can do so many different styles and genres with one guitar. It's just the style that you want in your head. And with that, it's got to be a guitar that puts a smile on your face. I believe guitar playing is very much in your head as it is in your fingers. So if you grin from ear to ear every time you look at your guitar, or even have it around your neck, standing in front of the mirror, singing into a hairbrush as if you were a kid, it'll make you want to practice your heart out. Some guitarists are lucky enough to have signature guitars, which are guitars spec'd for them by the company, so you can get your idol's guitar straight off the shelf. I mean, take this for example. This is a regular Stratocaster, an amazing versatile guitar. But Hendrix has a couple of variants of Strats as well, and the Hendrix Strats are really cool. Because Hendrix was a left-handed but played right-handed guitars upside down, his signature Strats have an upside-down headstock which kind of flips the length of the strings, so the tension on the lower strings is longer than the tension on the higher strings. It's kind of the opposite of this. And the fun thing as well, the bridge pickup on Strats are slanted, so they're slanted the other way on a Hendrix signature Strat because Hendrix's guitar was upside down and strung the other way. How cool is that? You can get guitars that kind of look like a Strat, but are more modernized for different artists. Ibanez have the RG range, which are that kind of double cutaway shape. And the signature model is like the Ibanez Gem for Mr. Steve Vai. Very similar to the Strat shape, but with some modern touches. It's got two humbuckers in and a single coil. This daft monkey grip, which is a staple for the Gem guitars. 24 frets, scalloped frets, so you can get to the higher frets. And one of my favorite little tricks is the input jack comes in down the way as opposed to out the bottom. So if you stand on your cable, it's not going to come out. And that is in this model and even the Gem Junior, which is the beginner one. It's awesome. Some signature guitars are personalized out of this world to get them exactly like the artists they're for. Let me know in the comments whose signature guitar this is. If signature guitars aren't your thing, let the style of music you enjoy guide your guitar purchase. Say if you're a blues guy, you can't go wrong with a Strat like I was talking about before. Guys like Hendrix and Stevie Ray Vaughan, to get that classic bluesy sound, you need the single coil pickups that come with a whammy bar and a five-way selector switch with really cool tonal options. If you like something a little bit heavier, say, follow me over this way. You can't go wrong with things like Les Pauls. Amazing things for a bit more heavier rock. These guys have humbucking pickups, which are dual-coiled pickups, a lot fatter sounding, a lot warmer sounding, and there's less hum. You can really get some grit out of these guitars. They've got set necks as well, so the necks are glued into the body as opposed to bolted on like they are in the Strats. Guys like Slash and Jimmy Page adore the Les Paul. Proper classic rock icon, the Les Paul, but what if you want something a little bit heavier? What if you want something that when you dig into, all the heads turn in the crowd? You can get a similar shape, even left-handed like this guy. For the heavy musician out there, get something with active pickups. Active pickups are pickups that are powered by a battery. There's a preamp inside, so pickups themselves are magnets with lots of wire coiled around them to the volume control, then the output jack. Active pickups have an active preamp for a bit more clarity, a bit more punch, and a bit more compression to make heavy music awesome. Look for brands such as EMG and Seymour Duncan. There was some Seymour Duncan blackouts in that amazing left-handed Jackson there. Perfect for metal music. And finally, the hollowbody guitar. There's a few more styles of guitar than this. I'm just kind of going over the general ones. Hollowbody guitars. Companies like Gretsch make these amazing things with hollowed out wings. Some of them have a center block down the middle to help with some sustain and to stop some feedback, but some are all hollow, which resonate like nothing else when you play them. It feels like an extra, like an instrument in itself, besides the fact it's being an instrument because it sings when you play it, reverberates through your entire body. These usually have filtertron style pickups in, which are kind of an amalgamation of a humbucker and a single coil. A bit more spank, a bit more high end, perfect for rockabilly, blues, and clean, twangy, jangly stuff. So that's the general guitar chat. But just remember, guys, you can't do anything with these instruments, even though some were designed for specific genres. You can play blues on a metal guitar, you can play jazz on a Strat. It's all finding what feels comfortable in your hands. And that's why coming to a PMT store is crucial. We can help you find a guitar that's perfect for you. So now you've picked your first brand new guitar. Now you have to find something so your neighbors can hear it. Your first amplifier and a great brand to start with is Blackstar. They have small amps around the house going all the way up to big amps that fill stadiums. Check out Gus G with Blackstar, amazing sounding things. Starting with this little small guy, guys like the ID Core and the Beam amps, tiny little amplifiers, perfect for in the house. There's headphone outputs as well, so your neighbors haven't got to hear all the time. Clean sounds, distortion sounds, crunch sounds, and lots of built-in effects. You can play music through it and jam along with your favorite tracks. They're awesome. Moving up to the slightly bigger range, like the Blackstar Silverlines, these come in little 20-watt combos all the way to these lovely 100-watt heads. Same kind of design as that, all solid state, so no valves yet. Different sounds, clean sounds, crunch sounds, distortion sounds, and lots of effects built in, so you haven't got to worry about any pedals. We'll get to that shortly. Blackstar again, going up to the HT range, which are the valve amps. Amazing things, multiple channels, clean channels, distortion channels, no effects. All of this lovely unit is built for making the best tone possible. These are amazing. Check out the Blackstars for your first amp. If everything I've said thus far has confused you and terrified you, I'm sorry, but thank you for staying this far into the video. There is a way you can get everything in one lovely package. Brands like Yamaha have the Pacifica Starter Pack, which is a guitar and an amplifier all in one lovely box. You just get one thing. The guitars are amazing, the Pacificas. There's a humbucker in the bridge, like the Les Pauls I was mentioning earlier, for those heavy, heavy riffs, and some single coils for when you want to get your Stevie Ray Vaughan or your John Mayer on. And the amps have clean sounds, distortion sounds, and lots of built-in effects all in one box. Squire do a starter pack as well, even a starter pack for bass. Check those guys out if the thought of getting two separate things is blowing your mind a little bit. But if you don't want to do the starter guitar kit thing and want to get your own individual guitar and amplifier, like I said, some amplifiers do have effects built in, but if you don't want that, if you want to rock like a valve amp for your first amp, welcome to the wild world of effects. It's an amazing rabbit hole to go down, and I'm not going to go too much in depth with it right here because you need to come into a PMT store and try them out for yourself. Get yourself a chorus, a reverb, a delay. They're amazing things besides being amazing names. Get yourself to your local store and get yourself some pedals. So then we'll have it, guys, a little buying guide for you on your first electric guitar. I hope you have a whale of a time. It's an amazing instrument to play. You're gonna love it. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMT UK on YouTube for lots more cool music and guitar related content. If you want any information on any of the guitars I spoke about here, or any more video blogs, all that malarkey on buying guides, getting your first amp, getting your first pedals, how effects work and all that, get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding PMT stores to check them out. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of guitars with fun filters on them. I've been Dagan, and I shall see you next time. Hope it helped. Cheers.